Shemuel bet, 2 Samuel chapter 16. And David had passed on a little from the summit, and saw Ziba, the servant of Mephibosheth, who met him with a couple of saddled donkeys, and on them 200 loaves, and 100 cakes of raisins, and 100 summer fruit, and a skin of wine. And the sovereign said to Ziba, "Why do you have these? And Ziba said, "The donkeys are for the sovereign's household to ride on, and the bread and summer fruit for the young men to eat, and the wine for the weary to drink in the wilderness." And the sovereign said, "And where is the son of your master?" And Ziba said to the sovereign, "See, he remains in Jerusalem, for he said, 'Today the house of Israel is going to return the reign of my father to me.'" And the sovereign said to Ziba, "See, all that belongs to Mephibosheth is yours." And Ziba said, "I have bowed myself. Let me find favor in your eyes, my master, O sovereign." And when sovereign David came to Bahurim, he saw a man from the clan of the house of Shaul, whose name was Shimei, son of Gera, coming from there. He came out, cursing as he came. And he pelted with stones David and all the servants of sovereign David, and all the people and all the mighty men were on his right and on his left. And this is what Shimei said as he cursed, get out, O men of blood, O men of Belial. Yah has brought upon you all the blood of the house of Shaul, in whose place you have reigned. And Yah has given the reign into the hand of Absalom your son. And see, you are in your own evil, for you are a man of blood." And Abishai, son of Zeruiah, said to the sovereign, "Why should this dead dog curse my master the sovereign? Please let me pass over and take off his head." And the sovereign said, "What have I to do with you, you sons of Zeruiah? For let him curse, even because Yah has said to him, 'Curse David.' And who should say, 'Why did you do that?'" And David said to Abishai and all his servants, "See how my son who came from my own body seeks my life, and how much more now this Benjamite. Leave him alone and let him curse, for Yah has spoken to him. If so be, Yah does look on my affliction, and Yah shall return good to me for his cursing today." And as David and his men went in the way, Shimei walked alongside him on the hillside and cursed as he went, and threw stones at him and kicked up dust. And the sovereign and the people who were with him became weary, and they refreshed themselves there. And Absalom and all the people, the men of Israel, came to Jerusalem, and Ahithophel was with him. And it came to be when Hushai the Archite, the friend of David, had come to Absalom, that Hushai said to Absalom, "Let the sovereign live, let the sovereign live." And Absalom said to Hushai, "Is this your loving commitment to your friend? Why did you not go with your friend?" And Hushai said to Absalom, "No, I am for the one whom Yah and this people and all the men of Israel have chosen, and with him I remain. And besides, whom should I serve? Should it not be before his son? As I have served before your father, so I am before you." And Absalom said to Ahithophel, "Give your advice. What should we do?" And Ahithophel said to Absalom, "Go into your father's concubines, whom he has left to look after the house, and all Israel shall hear that you have made yourself a stench to your father, and the hands of all who are with you shall be strong." So they pitched a tent for Absalom on the top of the house, and Absalom went into his father's concubines before the eyes of all Israel. Now the advice Ahithophel gave in those days was as if one had inquired at the word of Elohim. So was all the advice of Ahithophel, both to David and to Absalom.